Check, all good?
Yeah, we go.
All right.
Thank you for listening to this Crew Network production. You can now listen to all the Crew Network podcasts on thecrewnetwork.net. Live from the Crew Studios in Highland, California.
Check, 1, 2. Testing, testing.
It's time for the Bucks Effect with your host, Chuck Bucks.
Hi, I'm Chuck Bucks. To my right, I have the one and only Dick Power. Straight across from me, we got Drayvon. Drayvon's in the house.
What's up? What's up?
Oh, no. And on my left is fucking troublemaker. That's almost turning into a menace to society. The homeless Willy Wonka himself. Jumble DK Murphy.
The everlasting knob gobbler.
Hey, how's it going?
Jumble.
Jumble Murphy.
Jumble Murphy.
Dude, if it's not one thing, it's a fucking another thing.
Especially with you.
With you. Yeah. What the fuck is... So DK has had a hell of a week last week. More bad shit happened to him. I text him. I said, hey, dude, you need a spiritual healer or something, right? Am I right?
Yeah, he needs something.
Had a fucking hell of a week, right? More bad shit happened today. I don't even know if he wants to talk about it.
I doubt it. Them Euclideans.
He's had it in his head in shame.
But Euclideans, I'll let you talk about it. Because if not, I'm going to talk about it.
Euclideans are closed books.
I'm going to make this quick. Okay, so...
That's what she's.
Or is it he?
No, he did say that.
Either or. First off, me and my girlfriend kind of had a fight and broke up for a minute.
I didn't know you had a girlfriend.
Yeah. Remember Lena?
Mm-mm.
The one with the dick?
I mean, I know the name. the one with the dick.
Well, we know he likes that. So.
Lena with the dick. Yeah. Oh, yeah.
Her. Yeah, her. Yes, sicko.
She did the helicopter thing.
Her dick brought all her dicks in shame, remember?
She got mad at me over something really petty. It's not really worth talking about. I mean, if you want to know, I'll tell you, but I don't think it's really worth it.
Yeah, please save us.
No, we're good.
All right, so yesterday I went and picked up my paycheck. And like I said earlier, I got paid very well.
So like $400?
$15.
$15. For 1 month pay?
No, for 6 days.
Wow.
Damn, Mr. Moneybags over there.
Mm-hmm. What happened?
What do you mean what happened? I worked.
No, but like, you know, the other thing.
Yeah, the other thing.
Got him? What's going on?
All right. So, yeah, I'm in Big Bucks's kitchen, and I'm basically spitting up blood.
Doc
and he's like, hey, you scumbag.
Don't be spitting blood in my
this fucking sink. Okay, but rewind. I'm going to stop here. Hold on. Okay. Rewind. Last week, we did this show.
Oh,
okay?
God.
Now, if you listen to... if you listen to Huerto, which is on the... which is on Drayvon's podcast, you would listen to the other half of it was Shitgate 2023.
And
it didn't have to happen if Shitgate 2023, if he had a Lux Bidet. If he had a Lux Bidet, it would never happen. But,
right?
All right.
But he didn't. Shitgate happened. Listen to the episode. We won't go into it, but pretty much.
I'm going to go into it.
Okay, let's hear it.
Okay, first off, you need to do the math, okay? So I know you don't like me using your bathroom. So when I was in there, as fast as I could. Now... You go in there, and there's that little rim of number 2, right on the rim, right?
Okay.
Okay, how does one get a perfect little rainbow of poo on a rim?
With your ass? How? You motherfucker. We were trying to figure out the same thing.
It doesn't happen. It doesn't happen. It would be a smear. But you know what? It wasn't a smear. It was a little rainbow of a poo. Now, secondly, there was that dot of brown stuff on the panel of the light switch, right? Right?
Yeah, you tell me, motherfucker.
Yes, exactly. Okay. So, what you're telling me is that when I went to go turn off the light, I didn't flick the switch. I went, No, you flick a switch. You don't do this. And that also means that I had to have a whole bunch of shit on my finger to do that. And then on top of that, if you do the timetables, between the time that I walked back in here to when your wife came out and said, you know, clean up an aisle two, that stuff had dried.
Okay, so
that
let me tell you something, motherfucker. Okay, let me stop you there.
I'm not done.
Okay, hold on. Let me tell you. So you're telling me you didn't shit at all in that toilet?
I did.
Okay,
I did.
You did. Okay, you did. Okay, we got that. So did you have the shit swirls in the toilet bowl? Was that you? That wasn't you?
Shit swirls? What the hell?
Okay, so you know when you take a shit and it's real sticky shit, and then the shit around the bowl?
Yeah, that's when you had cheese.
No.
Do you admit to that? You don't admit to that? Okay.
No, here. Now, listen. I don't like admitting this, but here's why I know that shit wasn't me. You know why?
Why?
I have fucking hemorrhoids, asshole. So when I take a shit, it looks like a fucking abortion in the toilet bowl.
Oh, my God. I knew it was you. You know how I know it's you? Huh. And he even brought it up afterwards. Because you shit at an angle. I know how you...
Listen, I shit at an angle?
You shit at an angle.
What am I, Lee Harvey Oswald?
You do. And I know how you shit. You shit at an angle because... I know how you shit because every time you've taken a shit in my bathroom, there's always these unhealthy fucking shit streaks, okay? In the bowl, okay? I know how you shit because we figure out that you fucking lean towards like the toilet this way and somehow, some way, there's
shit
at
the
back of the fucking toilet, right? Yeah, so
sure.
I know, so don't bullshit me.
No, I know it was you.
Nobody else had to take a shit that day. Okay. So don't fucking lie to my face.
I'm not lying to your face, but here's the other thing. Is that between the time that I walked back in here and Michelle came back, that shit had dried?
Okay, do you mean I'm not saying
it was only like 3 minutes.
I'm not saying the handle, the switch. I never seen the switch, the poo on the switch. But you're admitting there was poo on the switch.
No, I'm admitting there was some sort of brown stain on the switch that was dry as fuck. But I don't know what it was. But it took me like a good minute to clean it up, because apparently I don't know how to use a light switch. Because apparently I go,
I didn't take a shit that night. And I didn't have chocolate.
And now here's a question. So here's a question for you.
That gets rid of...
Good sir. What time do you go number two?
What time do I go number two? Not a specific time.
What time do you go number two?
I would say probably when I wake up, I would say about 6:30 in the morning. If I
take
a guess.
What exact time? Exact time.
I see where you're going with this.
Yeah.
It's not fucking pivotal to what the information is, okay?
No,
you're saying,
no,
I have
no.
to take a shit. I know your point. I got to take a shit, and I don't know when I can take a shit. But let me tell you something. These boys here have been here for a long time, okay? How many times have you taken a shit in my bathroom?
Like maybe three or four.
3 or 4 out of, what, 10 years? Never took a shit in my bathroom. Never took a shit in my bathroom. So how can these guys... And myself, when I go to family members and I go to friends' house, not take a shit at their house?
I can answer that. Our dear esteemed colleague here has medical issues. He doesn't want to share it with us because I knew someone else who goes to the shitter all the time. Kentucky Fried Mike.
Kentucky Fried Mike shits all the time.
And he does have something wrong with his tummy. And he's not going to say what it is, but all these people they're always in the bathroom all the time. They don't want to say what it is wrong, but I know they got something wrong with their belly.
Yeah.
All right. Anyways, I'm just going to say this and we can move on and I can say about me getting my ass kicked today.
Okay.
I don't believe those stains were from me, but if you believe it, that's fine. We're friends. I'm not going to argue with you. I love you. You're a friend of mine. Uh-huh. I seriously do try not to use your bathroom. I really do.
Okay. I want to say something too. Okay. All right. Okay. So I don't know if that switch, I had never seen the shit on the switch. Okay. Was there cleaned up before I got there? Okay. Can't tell.
Uh-oh.
I did see it on the rim a little bit. There was a little bit of a light stain. Wasn't like a heavy stain. It was a little bit of a light stain. Kind of like when you have a dookie booty and then you kind of like, you know, right. I've done it before. Okay. I've done it before. I didn't do it to that toilet. Okay, There was some shit smears inside there. Whatever. Okay. Whatever. Whatever the case be. I know it was you. Okay. But that's okay. Okay. But I can tell you, Madison uses that restroom. Brandon uses that restroom. My wife uses that restroom. And I can tell you, me being the leader of the seven kingdoms, president of the Crew Network and the Prestige Film Festival, officially ban you from that restroom. Okay. So I get you have a medical condition, but you have to go to Carl's Jr. to take a shit, okay? That's just the way it is.
I got to go to Walmart to take a shit.
You go Walmart, you go to Carl's Jr. It's right up the street. You got to go there. And I'm just saying that because I got family.
You can go to Albertsons.
Or you can go to Albertsons.
Oh, yeah, and I'm sure I run into Madison.
That's
and
what I was thinking, like, how funny
hey.
That
would be. Hey! And I just...
You might want to tell a janitor
she's like,
about
it. Oh, fuck. And she's got bathroom duty. Yeah. She walks in and just jealous, like, huh?
I write
in shit.
Yeah, I write in shit. Joe was here.
And then right as you walk out, you hear, Joe!
I fucking love. Oh, please don't do that.
You pull the Clem Fandango.
Please don't do that.
All right, no, I really do honestly try not to use your bathroom. I'm not joking. I really don't try to use your bathroom.
I don't mind a shit here and there, but when a shit is constantly every fucking time, the shit's out of control. And I'll tell you, today kind of pissed me off too when you're bleeding and then that blood was inside the sink. All right, listen. I yell at Brandon for not cleaning up that sink when he spits out his toothpaste shit. I'm going to yell at you for not cleaning up your blood in the fucking sink.
Well, I had the faucet on. I thought it was going to go down.
There was nothing. There was still blood and spit in that sink. Don't tell me it wasn't, because I just seen it.
No, there was. There was. But it was only like 10 seconds before you showed up.
I'm just saying.
The thing is, here's what's weird, dude. You only saw the blood. When I went to the bathroom, I saw semen. So if he's spitting up blood and semen.
All right, so... Moving on.
Now
we change the subject.
I've seen semen. It's fucking done, son. Wow. You've seen semen. I'm fucking somebody up, dude.
I'll say this. The worst place to masturbate is in a porta potty at work.
What?
God damn it.
I don't even want to know.
Fuck! Fuck!
I don't want to know.
I get really bored at work and I'm a little horny and I'm like, hey, that's what porn. But I got to go someplace where I can be private. Oh, I got to go to the porta potty where I smell shit and piss and I'm just like, right.
So you know if you do that enough, right? There's guys who've been doing this so long that when they go to work, it becomes a thing where they can't really get off unless they go and jerk off in a porta potty.
Denied.
The reason I was bleeding so much because
that's real. It's real. It wasn't disgusting. Like.
Let's recap what happened, DK. Why is it? Give me your money.
Give me your money, bitch.
Yeah. So I got paid, you know, I went to go deposit my paycheck yesterday, and then,
Jesus Christ.
Hey, don't, look at that. Look at that, Tim.
Smoke weed every day.
Oh, stupid Tim.
God damn it, Tim.
Fucking idiot. Just put him on,
fucking idiot.
There was some, like,
put him on. He ain't gonna drop
moron.
Him.
Goofy homeless guy that saw that I pulled out some cash. He didn't know the amount, but he was like, give me your money, and he had a knife. And I said, no. And then he and I started to, you know, not necessarily fight, but he won the fight, but he just didn't get my money because it was like deep in my pockets and I wear my pants really high up. So it's like really hard to get into my pockets. And then I put on the Joker jacket.
Did you have the Joker jacket on?
No.
Because oh, you would have like, huh?
Because after that, I was bleeding in my car. Well, not in my car, but on the street.
Dude, you're the real-life Joker.
I guess.
Fucking losing a bunch of weight, getting beat up by fucking homeless people, trying to laugh, and no one's laughing.
Yep. Man, they should have had him instead of Joaquin Phoenix.
Dude, you're a real-life Joker.
Well, thank you. But anyways, yeah, so...
But not like the cool evolution, though. Yeah.
It's, it's the homeless version the homeless of the Joker. Version.
So that happened. Moving on, I'm not proud of myself, and I don't like that I've been bleeding in your sink and in your...
God damn it.
it's not something that I'm happy about. So okay, let's go make fun of a retard.
Well, before we do that, Timmy, why don't you go ahead and bless DK here so you can have some bad luck.
Bless DK with what?
Just bless him that he has good luck from now on. Just give him some kind of blessing. Just
from
some
a
kind
retard
of good prayer.
To a retard. I don't think that works that way.
Well, coming from you, Tim, surprise, that really hurts.
And this is how I
surprise,
saw
motherfucker.
You don't want to give him any advice?
I think he got it.
Yeah. No blessings? No, what are you doing? What are you doing, DK?
You'll learn.
I really don't go looking for this shit.
This is your fourth fight in within a week and a half.
Yeah, I know.
It's not good, dude.
It's not good.
Not good.
It's really concerning. I was going to fucking say, dude, just go home and fucking be by yourself. You find this cloud that's upon you.
Well, all I do is work and take care of my dad, so this is like my only time to relax, I guess you could say.
Fuck. It's just, I see this as a friend. Like I said, I want better for him. Right?
Yeah.
I think we all do. I just, this negative fucking cloud. One fight's a lot, right? I tell you guys about, if I had a fight this week, I'd tell you guys, and it'd be fucking like a great story, right? Yeah, win or lose. Four fights?
In a week?
Dude, it's a bit much.
2 weeks, damn.
That's a bit much, dude.
It is, and I'm not proud of it, and I really don't go looking for these things. It's just, I don't know. I am the knight.
Dude, shit.
All right, let's talk about a retard.
Well, I think what he's referring to is we have this character on the show, and we'll just call her Emily with the Downs. So we don't get sued. Okay? Let's just call her Emily with the Downs. So she makes, if you don't know Emily with the Downs, she makes these Instagrams. And I'm not going to give you the handle because, anyway, I don't want this shit to link up to me. Mm. But I am going to play her latest. And now it is a race. Now, look, you can tell how much I like these because I save them, different ones that make me chuckle. So there's one that DK hit me up recently, and it was like, he's like, dude, did you see the Emily with the Downs post? I'm like, dude, let me see it. He's like, it's super racist. So anyways, I'm going to play it for you. We'll talk about it. Here we go.
Are you sure that scares me? So my black classmate was wearing, like, really expensive clothing. And I don't know anything about, like, black culture. But something in me says that he might be affiliated with a gang. And I should tell the cops, right? Like, that's the obvious thing to do. So I'm gonna tell the cops. Because I'm afraid that he will die. Or that he will face a fate worse than death. So, if the cops contact you, I don't know your name, but if they contact you, please talk to them, because I'm scared for you.
Guys,
wow.
Guys, you imagine the 911 call on that? 911, what's your emergency?
There's this handsome black man with really nice clothes on. And
what kind of clothes, ma'am?
Nike.
Here's the thing. Oh, now we know that those 911 calls are also going out.
Oh,
like,
yeah.
How many?
Oh, my God.
We got to get a 911 operator on this show.
I
want to
say this. I want to say this. So, first off, she can ride dick like nobody's business, okay? I'm sorry.
Well, that's because she's been molested.
Yeah.
Yeah,
by everybody. Daddy taught her well.
So did uncle.
And her cousins.
And her cousins.
But like
NDK
with them good old boys on Indiana. Oh, sorry.
So I always thought maybe she had like Asperger's.
That's
yeah.
Or Mary Jane, one more time.
That's her real song,
whoa,
bro.
Did you just do a Tom Petty?
Yeah.
Dude. Oh shit.
That is a great song, too.
I always thought that, like, maybe she had Asperger's or that she was just socially awkward because, like, maybe she was, like, homeschooled. But after I heard that and then he hits me up, that was so funny. I just go, that dumb bitch.
Oh, God, dude. It's bad.
Yeah, and then she started posting, like, 20 videos about, like, her getting molested and other shit. And I was like, my entire Instagram feed is just her. And I'm like, oh, for fuck's sake.
Dude, and
you weren't even a little horny?
No. Oh.
Dude.
Wow. Emily doesn't do anything for him now.
It's kind of bad.
Yeah. Oh, her teeth are rotten, too, man. Her teeth are fucking rotten. She's always, like, when she does videos, too, it's always like a booger in her nose. It's always like a booger in her nose. I'm like,
surprise, I have a little friend. Say hello.
Bucks was joking that, like, we should have her on the show as, like, our little Robin Quivers or our Jamie, but always have her sit next to you.
Why me?
Oh, you know why.
Why not?
Yeah.
And just staring at her the whole time.
Yeah. Oh, I'll be staring more at her chest than her face, but, you know.
Yeah, well, it's even better.
Put a bag over her head, do your business.
Just trying to get my dick wet. Just trying to get my dick wet.
The response he gives.
Just trying to get my dick wet.
I'll bring the whiskey.
Ask her to sing Sweet
Caroline. It's so sad.
911, what's your emergency?
Yeah.
Sweet Caroline. Bum, bum, bum.
There's a black guy.
She's wearing expensive clothing. I'm in the gang.
Child, did you see my post?
No,
there's a black guy just saved his life.
There's a special place in hell for us.
Dude, I bet you 911 was like, where are you? Because we're going to arrest your ass.
I'm in my dad's basement.
I would give anything to hear that 911 call. Oh my God. I would
in my
love
dad's
to.
Basement with change.
Yeah.
I can't get out.
He barely feeds me.
He puts the lotion on his skin.
But he left me the cell phone to learn other sexual things from movies. But I've learned to call 911.
My dad showed me some movie called Debbie Does Dallas.
Listen, we told you don't call us unless it's an emergency.
This is an emergency.
How old are you?
38.
911, what's your emergency? Hi, what are you guys doing?
What? There's some big black dick. I want to ride it, but my daddy says I have to give him a lotion job tonight, and I ran out of lotion. If I get pregnant, he'll kill me.
And the baby.
And the baby.
And the baby. Oh, dear Lord.
That's fucked up.
It's fucked up.
And the baby.
You know how old she is?
28?
She's 27. Oh, I thought she was like 25.
I thought she was like fucking 42.
Fucking psycho.
She's
42. Yeah. Yeah,
she's this close to getting Social Security.
Oh. Yeah, when she hits 30.
Fuck.
Jesus.
Oh, we Help have us. Fun.
Oh, my God.
Lord. Oh, dear Lord.
There's always somebody out there more fucked up than you guys. Ladies and gentlemen, you've not heard that.
There's
someone always more fucked up than you.
For the people listening at home, you got to remember, as crazy as you think you are, trust me, there's somebody more fucked up than you.
Yeah, go to the mental asylums. You'll see them right there in those psych rooms.
Yeah. Hey, you're still fucking, though, right, Drayvon?
Sweet.
I fucked the sweet out of her.
Don't lie.
I like who had that look in his face like, I got to think about this. Yeah.
Quit goat thinking.
The computer's like, which answer?
As a matter of fucking fact, I would.
Yeah, I would.
She puts her picture on Tinder, and Tinder just breaks.
Oh, shit. Is there like a Tinder thing that's like for people who are like autistic?
Yeah. There might Why are you be, asking me?
I don't know. How'd you find Emily with the Downs?
Like OnlyFans, like Only Downs. Fucking new Down syndrome people.
Do you like when I take off my clothes?
Justin here, Jimmy.
Damn it, Mimble.
I like Damn it, Mimsy.
We like the brother from other songs.
Oh, hey, boss. Damn it, Mimsy.
I like titties and John Cena.
They all love John Cena. Yeah. If you see someone with the Downs and you do the John Cena fucking you can't see me, dude, they'll fucking lose their mind.
I just imagine she goes on like a real date and she goes, do you like crowns?
All right, that's too far.
Wait, when is it too far with us?
Just now.
Do you like coloring books?
Robert, if you guys stop making fun of me on the show.
You guys want to see some dark shit? Sure, Emily. I want to do an orgy with you guys.
Whoa,
Emily. Yeah, I want Chuck to dress like my dad and Joe to dress like my uncle.
Fuck. I like how we all have the one voice for her.
The rest of you couldn't jack off and watch.
Caroline.
If you pay extra, then you could watch
that video. I was joking. I was like, yeah, you could just send me a picture of your tits. I go like, oh, how about you dancing in your underwear to Sweet Caroline, JK. And the next day,
and I'm in like, your underwear, topless.
And I'm like, Jesus.
It cannot hold a tune to save her life.
No.
And then, so another good thing about her Instagram, another entertaining thing, not good thing. She she pretends she's an actress.
Oh, yeah.
But she'll do a voice like that's even more downer than her down voice.
She's
like this.
Oh. Actually, I think you're pretty. I want to.
Dude, I'm a player right now. I'm a fucking player. I'm a fucking player. Here we go.
Emily, you are a nice person, but motherfuck.
A week at least. After a week with me, you will want to marry me.
Was I kidding? Was I kidding?
Oh, no.
You do realize he listens to the show. She's going to commit suicide. She is. And that's why we're not on camera. And that's why we code these names, okay?
I actually honestly do believe that we should have her as our little, like, our Jamie or Robin Quivers and always have her sitting next to Drayvon.
Honestly, no, because here's the deal, dude. If she comes here and she listens to this shit and we rip on her, dude, we can be responsible for her death. Yeah. Yep, and there'll be a whole bunch of, and when who knows what she'll say. If she's telling Instagram that she's getting molested by her dad and her uncle, dude, you imagine when, if she was here, you should watch out too, buddy. All the shit you made her do with the fucking Downs.
What did I do? She sucked my dick, which, by the way, she's not very good at sucking dick.
Well, just see her mouth. Dick will dissolve.
Look at Bucky Beaver.
Do you like my ginger pussy?
But honestly, Tim, would you let her lay?
Oh yeah, Timmy would.
No, I wouldn't.
Yeah, you would.
Oh, you fat fucking liar!
Hey,
didn't we have a dating game with her on it? Right?
Yeah.
Didn't I blow that dating game for Javon can go out with her on it?
Oh, I thought you just. Lost it because
you're Timmy.
Because you're Timmy. I didn't think you blew it. It's you.
Hey, it's you. If I wanted to fuck her, I would have fucked her on that dating game show, right? That's what I'm saying. If I wanted
that sounds like rape right there.
I think you should go on a date with her, though. Let's just arrange it. Let's arrange the fucking date. Because it'll be the funniest date ever.
Dating game part two.
He's like, fuck, I'm about that. She's like, I'm not about that shit. She's like, come on. Let's fuck.
Come on, Timmy.
I'm gonna shuck your cock.
Timmy.
Yeah, hell no. Fuck off, bitch. Oh, come on. You want to marry me?
Oh my god!
All right. We're gonna go commercial break. More Bucks back when we come back. All right. Tons of fucks.
There can only be one.
Are we recording?
We're back.
Yeah.
That's you, Em. We're back, ladies and gentlemen. There's film festival we're going to tonight.
Woo!
And it is the Mentone Film Festival, man. We're going to the Mentone Film Festival. And so he hit me up and, you know, he said, hey, you know, you guys going to make it to the film festival? I made it to the last. I was like, okay, cool. Yeah, you made it to the last one. And he said, hey, you, me, and Christopher, we go over there, right? You know, like I was like Tony Soprano.
I was about to say, like, what are you, the fucking
you,
Sopranos?
Me, and Christopher, all right? We're going to fucking chop his balls off and then we're going to go to Bada Bing afterwards.
You're goddamn right.
I've been working on my Soprano.
Hell yeah.
Yeah, dude. But anyways, that's where we're going. Okay, we're going to the film festival.
Woo!
And you're not. You're not. So I did say, hey, I said, guys, dress nice. This is what I said. I told you guys, right?
Mm-hmm.
So we got the homeless fucking Willy Wonka. I said, what are you wearing, dude? I said, a button up or something. This
we
motherfucker,
got a casual Friday.
This motherfucker
Jason
is wearing a purple trench coat from Halloween, okay, when he was the Joker, a T-shirt.
No, first off,
what does the shirt say? Stand up a little bit.
I don't fucking know what the
shirt
says.
What does the shirt say? You don't even know what it says?
Glow stick.
I got this from my dad.
It says glow stick.
It says fucking rhinestone cowboy.
Yep. Something gay.
Then we got Drayvon here with his grease pants. He's saying that's his best pants.
This is Casual Friday Jason.
Casual Friday fucking Jason, dude. He looks like a lumberjack, dude. This is the look when you do cut down trees. And then Timmy was sporting it with the dinosaurs and the pizza and the Flavor Flav hoodie and
Flavor Flav.
I can't take you guys anywhere. But we're going to get some Chinese food because in case they kick us out, because, you know, it's probably going to happen. But we're going to get some Chinese food. And, you know, also because it's a budget thing. I know there's not a lot of money going on here. I mean, DK has money.
We're going to get kicked out because of me.
So I'm sure
he'll start another fight.
That's probably what's going to happen.
DK is like our dinosaur from Jurassic Park. Some of the sort of shit. DK is like purple jacket goes... And he spits blood in their face. Then we all get away.
when I get bored at work, I listen to one of the older Bucks Effects episodes, and I still just laugh my ass off at the cackle that I get out of this motherfucker. When I told him how my dad took me to Lost Lake, and I said, he didn't sound like it, but it reminded me of this. When we got to Lost Lake, my dad was like, there it is. So he sounded like the
like
guy
Jurassic
from,
Park.
Yeah, he sounded like the guy. The old man from Jurassic Park. There it is. There it is.
Yeah, that was funny.
You sound like
your dad took you to Lost Lake.
Yeah. Oh. You ever been there?
I know the name of it, but I don't think I've been there.
Yeah, I've never
been
there.
Let's go, bro.
We'll do a Lost Lake commercial. I mean, we already listened to a Lost Lake commercial. Is that what I meant?
Yeah.
Ooh.
You fucked up, man.
You know what we should do a Bucks Effect over at the...
Lost Lake?
Lost Lake.
Yeah, let's do it, man.
Like the Ghost Adventure.
We need power, motherfucker.
Oh, no, I meant the...
Use your fucking phone.
No, I meant doing the Ghost Adventure stuff over at Lost Lake.
The what? The ghost... Oh, ghost hunting?
Yeah, ghost hunting.
Oh, dude, you know what's funny? Well, it's not funny, but like I said, you know, hey, Dad, I think I might just go to Lost Lake on my own tomorrow night. And he goes, don't do that.
Lost Lake, is that east of us?
Yeah.
Oh, so there's some fucking shit going on at night. What did he say? Like a lot of crackheads.
He was like, it's
and pit bulls.
The wilderness, yes, but apparently there are some spirits or ghosts out there.
Is that what he said though?
Yeah.
Ooh, all right.
Might be a place to check out.
Yeah.
So, yeah, he's like, I said, like, hey, I'm going to go there at night. And he says, don't do that.
Yeah, there's a homeless man called Brutus. Looks like a ghost, dude. It's all fucking ashy and shit.
He's all, give me your money, bitch.
Hold on there. You make a trace.
Your money or your chase transaction.
Give me your chase money, boo.
You got a pretty mouth. But it was, no, we should definitely go out there. Just fucking, I don't know, you record with our phones. It'll be,
Sure.
It'll be shitty audio, but it'll still be audio.
Yeah, let's do it.
I'm down. We'll set a schedule a couple of weeks from now.
Yeah. We do actually have a film festival coming up. Well, not necessarily coming up soon, but April 2024. Ladies and gentlemen, the return of the Prestige Film Festival.
Woo!
Now, guys, this time the third annual Prestige Film Festival. We're very, very picky on the selection here. Okay, it's not like we're just picking anybody. There's only going to be maybe a fucking small amount of films because we only have so much time. And there's right now over 200 submissions.
And most of them are shit.
We did actually get some shit ones in the beginning. There was actually shit smeared to the envelope. I blamed him, but DK swear
courtesy
it wasn't him.
Of DK.
DK is like, I didn't submit this one.
But it did say courtesy of DK, so I'm kind of curious.
Fuck you.
No, thank you.
You're cool. Fuck you,
no,
man.
Thank you.
So we're going to do that, but there is a lot of films that we're going to watch. Should be fun. I mean, hopefully we have a blast doing it. But yeah, for sure. Guys, we got to do some more The Bizarre and Unexplained. Yep. That podcast.
Oh, yeah there
podcast.
We go.
That's still a podcast. The Return of Dick Power is, we already have an episode in the can, and we're going to premiere it.
Woo-hoo.
It's not the best, but it's an episode. Well, we're going to return that to the Crew Network. What else we got going on the horizon? We got, hopefully we do some filming, guys. I mean, because like I said, when June hits, I'm gone.
Yeah.
I'm fucking gone. So I'm hoping that we can put a film in, play it at the film festival that we did, and that's and do that and do the film festival and wrap up the show in June. That's my goal. And
I'm
stick to my goals, guys. So we're going to do it. We're going to fucking do it.
Let's say you don't do it.
And I'm
going
to fuck a retard.
Oh, so you're going to do it.
only when I open my eyes.
Make her sweet Caroline.
Boom, boom. I just imagine that, like, Bucks wakes up getting ready for work, and then he sees me banging Emily with the Downs in his living room, and he's like, what the fuck?
This is never going to put it past me. I was like,
I go, hey, Bucks, give me just 1 minute.
A homeless man fucking a girl with Down syndrome in the fucking.
Yeah. He's like, I'm sure there's a federal offense going on right now.
Dude, racist Downs.
He's all, how'd you get in my house? And he looks over at his back window and it's broken.
Squatters! Yeah. Squatter rights!
Instead of Emily with the Downs, now it's racist with the Downs. Yeah.
She has evolved.
Cops.
Yeah. Oh my God.
911. What's your emergency?
This episode
has, black man.
This episode has to be called "Emmy with the Downs is Racist."
No, dude. we don't title those things with her name.
Oh, like she fucking listens.
She like probably like she knows how to press play.
Hey, didn't she binge listen to like a bunch of our shit one time?
No. She doesn't listen to our shit.
I could have sworn she said she did.
You said that last time, and then before she was a guest the first time, she binge listened to like 15 episodes.
I think she watched maybe an episode on the YouTube. Because we fuck with people on the YouTube. But
either way,
there's not a lot of people like.
This is still a rocky situation.
We do have our listeners that listen, like, you know, the traditional, like, whatever, certain parts, but their YouTube, it's all over the place.
Some poor bastard stuck in some hills who listens all the time. He's like, I don't do a lot, but if there's one thing I'll be goddamned if I'm going to do is I'll miss an episode.
God damn it.
Oh,
who knows?
Dude. Oh, wait. I don't think you were here for this.
Probably not.
So I was doing one of my midnight walks around my neighborhood,
mm-hmm.
and I was listening to our latest episode, and there's this guy. He looks straight up like the wettest wetback you can think of.
Oh, you did tell me this. This is right before, yeah.
And as I walk past, he can hear my phone, and he goes, "Is that the Bucks effect?"
You're so bullshit. I gotta make think he's lying at some point.
Look at that smile. He's
like,
lying.
I was like, Juan?
Juan Cias? Juan Cias, like, oh, hey.
Just picking up a dead body here.
Yeah, you didn't see nothing.
Yeah.
No, legit. Like, he was like 2 blocks away from my house, and like, I'm just listening to the podcast, and he goes, "Is that the Bucks effect?" And I was like, "Fuck me. You know the Bucks effect?"
But well, you want him to fuck you?
Before I could even ask him any questions, he went into his house.
Okay.
He had on this wife beater.
Okay. That was my brother Eddie. I'll tell you. I put him up to it.
He looked like Eddie, but shaven.
Yeah, that was Eddie. So it happens that Eddie shaves.
Oh, so you want, yeah. Guys. Yeah, that's a thing, dude. So I did. I went and did comedy yesterday, and we did all right. We did all right.
I think we killed.
Obviously, if you haven't seen Dick Power live, he does, jokes.
There's
a particular Cosby joke that he does, right?
I was going to say,
that is my favorite joke of all time.
Did he kill it?
Not because it's funny.
It is funny. God damn it, it is funny.
It's because of the commitment that he does and how people feel uncomfortable when he says it.
Okay, I got a question on that.
Funniest thing I've ever seen.
Did he actually get the room to laugh? Like when
I was dying and I didn't care if anybody laughed.
Yeah. I did. There was.
I was laughing so hard that I was getting other people to laugh.
We turn off the recording and he's all, "My grandfather made that joke."
Dude, it is my favorite. If he says it, so anyways, there was a couple kids like at the brewery at the time, and then Adrian went up and he bombed. He always bombs. I love him to death, but he bombs.
He's the worst one of them all.
And
he is the bus from
there
Speed.
Was these fucking kids, two little kids, right? And he's like, "Well, I have to warn you, I do see some kids here. They might learn a few new words," right? Which is funny. That's actually pretty clever.
Yeah.
I told Dick Power before he went on, I'm like, "Hey, go to the crowd and say, 'I apologize. Oh, I see some kids are here. I'll try not to say as many pussy jokes.'" And I was like, "Dude, say that." I said, "Say that and I'll fucking cry laughter," right? So he doesn't say it at first. He does his Cosby thing. But then he's all, "I apologize. I'm going to watch it and not say as many pussy jokes." I fucking lose it, dude. That's well the funniest fucking line ever.
Well done, my God, dude.
You have to. You're bringing your kids to a brewery. Yeah. You fucking fuck. Yeah. And it turns out it's my boy Corey's stepkids because his ex was there. And those were his stepkids that he damn near. So that's why they were there. Whatever. I mean, like I said, I brought my kids there. My kid went up there and did stand up too. Technically, he's a paid stand up comedian.
Yeah. He's a professional stand up.
A professional stand up. But yeah, so he said that shit, dude. I was fucking crying in laughter. But yeah, I went up and did a few jokes. And whatever, like I said, it was the same crowd. We were talking to CW, which is a comedian there, afterwards. He's a teacher too, and he does a bunch of other shit. But he wrote a book, and I was talking to him about his book. But I lend Dick Power the book first. Did you read any of it?
I started reading it out loud to Tim over here.
Yeah.
So, I mean,
just for jokies.
So I'm such an asshole.
I don't think CW is going to listen to this. So go ahead.
Yeah,
he might be on the show soon.
But I will say that CW, I get the feeling maybe he doesn't like me because maybe I remind him of a student that he didn't like or something.
Right,
you're an asshole.
But yes. I get the feeling.
Cosby joke that no one laughs at.
I almost get the feeling that the guy in the book he's writing about is like a richer version of me. I'm like, how does CW hate me? Then it occurs to me, I'm like, because I'm the guy in the book. He may not like it, but that's going to be my review on Google or on Amazon. My bad, Amazon.
So I got a short story for you.
Uh-oh. All
right. This is another Dr. Seuss. They always rhyme.
Fish,
I hate
two
it.
Fish, yeah. Three fish, four.
When I'm taking care of my dad, my mom will go to this bar that's like just around the corner from their place, and I'll go there strictly for karaoke. Now, this one guy comes up to me, puts his hand on my shoulder, and it's like, well, how the hell are you doing? And I'm like, I'm good. Hi. Do I know you? You know, do I know you? And he's all, you don't recognize me, do you? I said, no, but don't feel bad about it.
He goes, I delivered you 40 years ago on the radius night father. Ever.
Julian, it's our father.
Roberto.
Can't believe you don't recognize me.
But it was that guy whose house you were living in. Off of Valencia.
Oh, Jeremy.
Yeah, Jeremy. Yeah.
How did you not recognize Jeremy?
Well, I ran into like once or twice. It's not like I'm.
I mean, Jeremy on here. That's
you've been running
here?
Into Jeremy off and on.
Yeah,
for like
he's been here
10 something years.
Well, yeah, white shaved head. That's our. Yeah,
I remember you. I remember you. I remember you. I remember you. I don't fucking remember some guy that comes.
Dude, he's here every fight.
That's what I'm saying.
All
crazy
the fights
that
we ever
don't
do.
Recognize
if we bring
Jeremy
people over, he's always here.
Other than Shiesty. And your wife and your right. wife's sister.
He's got to go.
I'll take fucking too much alcohol at night, eliminating my memory for $200, Bob.
How do you not?
Like, for $600, Alex.
Yeah. So then what happened? Okay,
that's
so
a daily double.
That's crazy. So Jeremy. Okay, what bar was this?
It's called The Bell.
I do
oh,
know
yeah,
about.
He goes there all the time.
Yeah, he does.
Yeah, he goes there all the
and
time.
And I was just there hanging out with my mom, waiting to do my karaoke.
Is that the one here in Highland?
Yeah.
Yeah. It's not too far from
the
here.
Little hidden gym, the little motorcycle one? Yeah.
Yeah.
It's a motorcycle bar, yeah.
But I never paid attention to him, so I just didn't know who he was. But then he said, hey, you know, Richard was living in my house. I was like, oh, okay. Now I know who
you are. Jeremy's cool as fuck.
All right.
Dude, are you drinking? Every night now? Again?
No.
Don't lie to me.
No.
You're drinking at all every day? Don't fucking lie to me now.
He says no, and then he pounds the hand. Hey, he says no, but then he pounds the hand sanitizer?
No.
I would never.
No, I can't.
What are you talking about?
I can't do that anymore.
Know any hard liquor.
This is water.
No.
It's not vodka.
I mean, it's hard liquor, it's beer, but I can't do it every night, especially because now that I'm working 12-hour shifts.
What do you do to fall asleep then?
I'll take like a melatonin or maybe a sleeping pill.
Melatonin or a sleeping pill, huh?
Yeah.
Slap my head into a wall 10 times. Watch 1 hour of child porn.
You would know.
Drink a gallon of milk and I fall asleep.
Yeah, especially if you have to watch a child porn. Yeah. You gotta drink that milk.
Hey, we don't do that around here. That's disgusting.
He's the one that brought it up.
I didn't say any names. I just said purple coat.
Hashtag. You just said purple coat.
No.
Hashtags purple coat, black beanie.
To be quite honest, I have definitely cut down my drinking. Only drink on the days that I work and don't work. I do 12-hour shifts, and basically when I get home, I only have 2 hours to chill out. So that means I really can't get, like, hammered or anything like that.
Mm.
So when I get home, all I really do is I get on my laptop, I watch some shows on Dopebox, and then I go to bed.
Did you ever catch up on that Grimm?
On what?
Grimm.
No. Asshole. I'm not queer.
This is coming from a guy who liked this. This coming from a hardcore Buffy and Spike and Angel fan.
And he hasn't, not queer, but
and he hasn't watched Grimm from the same people. What a faggot.
No, but also,
this is not queer.
I gotta take care of my dad.
He's
and almost every other day. Ooh. We have to take my dad to the hospital.
You don't have to.
Yes.
Yeah, you don't
you
have
see
to
what I mean?
That.
You're a good person. You got to look at yourself and say, hey.
Technically, you don't have
to. Hey, I didn't have to do that for my dad.
Right.
But
I wanted to.
Yeah.
That's true. Good point.
So thanks, I'm not going to drive from Highland to St. Bernardine's and or hospitality with alcohol in my system. So, like, this is actually basically, this is the first thing that I've had to drink in about 5 days, maybe six.
Wow.
Now,
that's a record.
Now, Dick Power, do you believe that?
I'm gonna talk to a guy real quick and we'll see.
Okay.
Right, you guys ready?
He's praying right now. He's praying. He's got. He's got.
I came back very quick, very fast, very loud.
Yeah. What did he say?
He's absolutely telling a fucking lie.
Oh, fuck.
God says this guy's been drinking in a car while crying and asking many different gods, not just the Muslim one, for advice.
Fuck.
And yet the only one who's actually listening is our Christian God, and he feels sad because he's not praying to him. That's okay, what
first
I heard all that within a second.
God is sad.
God said a lot of things.
First off, there is only one God. Allah is just another name for God, asshole.
Well, he doesn't like being called Allah, I'll tell you
right now. It's God or nothing, damn it.
I'm just telling you what he told me in a sec.
Now,
I don't like being called Allah. I'm God.
He said it sounds like gibberish.
I'm gonna tell you this one little quick story. It's very short, very short.
Yeah, that's what I said about the last one.
And this is where I want you guys to know that, no, I'm not drinking as much. So when I took my dad to get to the radiologist 2 days ago, I take him to get radiology, and then he has to go give blood at a different place. And I say, all right, Dad, we got to go. We got to go. And he goes, let's get some beer again.
Hell yeah.
Mm-hmm.
All right.
And he's like, let's crack some between
Steve Weiss's.
After we give blood.
What?
Yeah.
Pete Deborah.
Yeah. After we give blood, let's crack some beers. And I said, Dad, I have to drive to Fontana to pick up my paycheck.
So I'm only going to have three.
I might have four.
A responsible you, Clea, will only have three beers when he has to drive.
So four when we get there.
Two at home and one on the way.
Yeah. Three before we get there. Four on the way.
So I say to my dad, I said, Dad, I have to drive to Fontana. I don't think it would be a good idea to even have one tall boy in my system and then drive from Highland to Fontana. And on top of that, I'm going to be picking up my paycheck from my boss. Even though it's my day off, I don't think it'd be a good idea to pick up my paycheck from my boss with beer on my breath. And he goes, yeah, that sounds about right. So guess what, assholes? You can all fuck yourselves.
That's not a good story.
You hear the crickets? You hear the crickets?
Yeah.
Wait.
I just figured she was a raging alcoholic.
Ten in the morning.
Are we still doing Dumb and Dumber jokes?
Oh, yeah. Cue the crickets!
Samsonite. I thought it was way off.
So there's a new drinking game on the show. Anytime DK bombs, we all have to take a shot.
Oh, okay? My God.
There it is.
Hey.
All right, well, why don't we get some food? I think we should get some food.
We should definitely get some food. And, guys, that's it. I mean, like I said, I don't owe you an hour program. No one's paying me.
Damn, no one's paying you.
Okay, you're not paying me. So, I mean, the network pays me, okay?
They pay me very
handsomely. And that's why I have a lot of money, and these guys don't. But they're the Whack Packers, dude. You know what I'm saying? I had to pay a lot of money to get Dick Power back.
Yeah.
But the Whack Packers, they practically work for free. Nope. Timmy, any last words?
I mean, forever, because we're going to kill you after this. They're laughing because they know it's true.
Trayvon, you got any plugs?
No, just... hopefully do another Metal Asylum probably next Friday or something.
Why you don't even advertise the Metal Asylum that we produce now?
So there's also one that I do. It's called the Psycho Metal Asylum. Last episode was, I don't know what happened on the last episode.
That's one where I sabotaged you.
Yeah, you probably did, you fuck.
Where toe? DK did say, I'm going to make sure he has a shitty episode.
Fuck. Literally was
fuck
shitty.
You.
It was where toe went in the shit gate.
Yeah.
DK.
But yeah, that'll be coming up.
divine blessings. Make sure you stay away from the black cloud that has surrounded you last several 48 years.
48? Stay away from Chuck Buck's freaking bathroom.
No, don't go to my house anymore. Don't go in my house. If you got to bleed on your period or take a shit, it's always done at Carl's Jr.
from Albertsons.
Or Albertsons. Our Albertsons. Not at my house. Okay?
All right, you're going to pay for my gas, right?
That's me. I don't give a fuck. I'm not paying for your fucking gas. If you do that shit, I'll whoop your ass. And I'm in charge of the Seven Kingdoms. Remember that. Okay? I'm the king of the Seven Kingdoms. All right. That's all I got, guys. Also, listen to us every Thursday at the Three Iron Brewery.
We do jokes, guys.
6 p.m., you fucks.
And maybe I'll do some stand-up dates, dude. Maybe I'll do it. Maybe I won't.
Yeah.
Depends how much my ex says that, like, she heard your comedy, his comedy, and my comedy, and she thinks that we should go to L.A.
We should go to L.A. You heard it.
Go to L.A. Woo!
And if I get mobbed and killed, I blame her.
Hey, but on the side, though, what does she think about Dick Powers' comedy?
She doesn't like the comedy.
It's working!
I knew it!
Yeah, guys!
Joe stinks!
That's all I got like for you. Ass. Ladies and gentlemen, again,
I like how we whispered, but like crew, he's right there.
TheCrewNetwork.net for all your funny shit. Bye! Emily with the down. She grew up tall and she grew up right with them Indiana boys on an Indiana night.